As part of the Image Factory's 10th anniversary, the Art Foundation is holding a photographic exhibition titled Latta Pickchaz.
But it's more than just an art exhibit, it's a historical exhibit. It's very hard. We could do an exhibit every month for the rest of our lives to showcase all the photos that we have found of Belize now. But it's one little peep into the history of Belize through photography.
The pictures capture life between 1895 and 2005, taken by over 35 different photographers.
Half of them, we don't really know who they are. We've had them through the Craig family collection, the Eric King collection, personal collections, and the Belize Archive Department. Not everybody were established, like names like Avery and Evans, who were like, I think they worked for the government at the time, so they had their own studios and other family studios that established. But there were many other photographers who were out there, and their images were collected, but they weren't really documented.
Image Factory's curator, Gilvano Swayze, says some of the shots taken are on par with today's contemporary images. In this case, it is the mix of the new and old that makes for the latest in a string of well-received shows.
A regular exhibit, like say a painting exhibit or sculpting, more art now, would take us at least three to four months. Getting in touch with the artists, getting them prepared, getting the things together. We usually need at least 2 weeks before the show to catalog it, to create a nice catalog, set out invitations. A show like this takes even more time, and we kind of crammed it up into a regular show, like 3 months. We had to go and dig up a lot of info, find out where the images came from, of course, to give proper credits, try to identify the images, give them a time period, the photographer, the subject, and most importantly, every time there's new images being found, and so you have to go through a selecting process, not being biased, but try to pick things that at the end of the day complement each other.
The 80 pictures on display were chosen from a selection of 500 photographs.